Shalom, everybody. It's me, Miss Tall 23. I'm going to start saying that instead of hello. Shalom. It's if you don't know, it's the Hebrew word for peace. It's a greeting commonly used by people who speak Hebrew. So today I'm doing part two of the video that I started yesterday. This is also episode two in my series about the Guide to the New World Order, where I'm going through this hierarchy pyramid that I drew, and then I'm going to talk about a basic timeline and explain how they've had a hand in many events throughout history, and how they've tried to control us throughout history, and how this basic pyramid formed. And like I said, some of this may be a little off in the middle, but for the most part, I believe it's right. And if I'm wrong about some of this, maybe I'll discover it throughout my research and doing this, doing these videos. So yesterday I went through the first five of the nine areas of control. That was media, education, health, courts, and religion. And today I'm going to do the final four, which I only talked about briefly in the introduction yesterday, and that is military, intelligence, treasuries, and police. I'm going to explain how they try to, how the New World Order and uses different national governments, which use these four, just like they use the other five from yesterday, how they use them to try and control you and try to control the world. Some of these aren't, in some countries, they're not as dangerous as they are in countries like America, for example. Health, like I talked about yesterday, they don't fluoridate the water in most of Europe, and there are some countries in Europe where they don't have GMO foods, so that's one thing. Well, today I'm going to start with military, and I'm going to get right into it instead of talking with an intro for a while, so the video definitely isn't going to be as long as it was yesterday, so I'm going to begin. Military, they control with wars and conquest. In the Bible, it speaks of four horsemen. They're not actual horsemen; they're symbolic, so they're not actual people. But it's how the new it's as the authority of Hasatan is being stripped away, and as Yeshua slowly gaining control of the earth, the people who are allegiant to him kill using conquest, and the second one is war. Those are the first two horsemen. And the way that they do this, by the way, the example I gave was NATO. I drew the little NATO flag on here. People create alliances, military alliances, in order to improve their control over people. So when wars actually come, there will always be larger wars. There will be larger alliances, and large alliances are what lead to world wars. For example, World War One. They have the Triple Entente and the Triple Alliance. Those two alliances, and how they created alliances with other countries, even though they weren't considered part of like the Triple Alliance or the Triple Entente. There was only three, obviously, because it's triple. In each of those, certain nations were allies with other nations, and that's why in like the first few weeks it was like a chain reaction, and many countries joined almost instantly. So they use conquests in order to expand their control over different nations who try to resist their order, and who try to resist everything that they try to put on people and on their nations. For example, Russia, Vladimir Putin. He's actually, unlike the globalists who are in support of people like ISIS, although they claim to be bombing them, even though they're against the Syrian government, which is trying to fight ISIS, and they're trying to arm the rebels who are allied with ISIS. Putin realizes that maybe you should make alliances with other nations that are trying to fight ISIS, especially Syria, and that you should focus and primarily target ISIS instead of targeting the people who are fighting ISIS and helping the people who are allied with ISIS, because that's not how you would defeat them. And Russia is very, although it's been years since the Soviet Union fell, it's been 25 years now since the Soviet Union fell, many people are still don't really understand that Russia is our ally now. They're not, obviously not the ally of the United States, because the United States has fallen under the control of the New World Order globalists, so that's a bad thing. But Russia earnestly wants to, although, yes, Vladimir Putin is a bad person, I agree, in some parts, but he does want to keep the world from going to war. Although NATO is trying to expand their troops, they're training over near the Russian border, moving weapons closer. They're pretty much threatening Russia, and Russia could destroy them easily, everybody in NATO. So that's how they try to control using wars and conquests. They try to expand their empire and their control so they can put in all these other areas of control, and so they can set up corporations there, they can set up central banks there that ultimately go back, all their money and resources ultimately go back to the Vatican and their goal of conquest. The fourth, or I mean the second one, this is the seventh one in total, is intelligence, and they control with surveillance. They have control of surveillance. And the two examples I gave were the CIA and the NSA. And one thing that I really want to point right now is that both the CIA and the NSA have a great Catholic majority, and many of especially in the CIA, many of the directors in the past have been Jesuit trained at Jesuit universities, or have had part of another secret society like Skull and Bones or the Knights of Malta. The three founders of the CIA, two of them were Knights of Malta and one of them was a Freemason. Although historically, before the Illuminati was founded, Freemasons were, although it was mostly a Catholic society, but there were also Protestants and other people in it, it was taken over, the control of it was taken over mostly by Catholics, and now it is a mostly Catholic secret society, Freemasonry is, and so CIA is a mostly Catholic group, and it's very rare to see someone who isn't a Roman Catholic or who hasn't been to a Jesuit university, or who isn't part of Skull and Bones or Knights of Malta or Knights of Columbus. A similar thing with the NSA, although not as much as the CIA. And the goal of intelligence and surveillance is like George Orwell's 1984, where they constantly spy on you, constantly see what you're doing to try to limit what you say, and try to keep you in a state of fear, but also to know when to take certain people out. And I know this actually just happened a few days ago. WikiLeaks revealed some documents from the CIA that they were hacking into smart TVs and other smart devices in order to spy on people and to listen in on people. That is one example of how they do this. And they try to do this in order to learn information about what people think and what people do. And obviously, back in 2001, after the September 11th attacks, the Patriot Act was passed, and that is one of the reasons why why the September 11 attacks were faked and why they were done so they could introduce the Patriot Act in order to justify spying on us for fighting terrorism, to find terrorists. But really, that's not what they're doing. They just want to control our personal lives, try to limit what we say, try to ruin our lives if we stand up to what they want, and try to control us using this surveillance. And that was the point of the Patriot Act. That's the point of the NSA now and the CIA. And they've always, the CIA has always had control over other things too. I haven't really explained much of this yet on my channel, but I will explain it, especially in this series, that the CIA is responsible for the death of John F. Kennedy, along with the FBI and probably the Secret Service as well. The third one that I'm talking about today are treasuries, or just any government group that has to do with money. They control taxation, and they have control of money, but not exactly all of the money. They just control your money. The big banks control a large portion of the money, and the central banks control the nation's money. But the treasuries, and the example I gave is the IRS, they collect taxes from people, and although they say that these taxes are for better things or for good things, it mostly funds all of the bad things that I've talked about over here before, and also it goes towards their operations, their wars, everything that they need to do in order to enforce their control in the world and try to create a new world order. That is the point of taxation. I believe that there shouldn't be any taxes at all. In nations, like socialist nations, where there have been a lot of taxation, there's been less prosperity among people, there's been a lot more poverty and a lot less happiness. In places like where there's a little bit lower taxes, it's a little bit better, and when the taxes go down, normally jobs go up and prosperity goes up. Well, I think there shouldn't be any taxes at all, first of all, because we don't need to, because it's our hard-earned money, and although I do believe in giving out and helping people, I don't think we should give it to the government so they can help people, because usually they don't really help people. They help themselves, and or their help that they give them, doesn't help them at all, and it makes them worse, and it also makes our lives worse as well. So I don't believe that we should give any taxes to the government. I don't think we should pay any of that at all. I think that there shouldn't be any. There should be 0% of our 0% of our wages, and 0% of our wages should be given as tax. Because they can pay for it themselves. You know, you have some of the people in these governments are extremely rich. Some of the people in corporations, certain corporations, are extremely rich. The central banks have a lot of money. They have enough money to do all this stuff on their own. They just carry out all their plans. They need our resources and our money for that. Or they may, some of their things may fail, but that's also why they're trying to create a socialist nation, so they can take more of our money. But they can do fine with running the government, running the nation without our money. They just want to take it from us to make sure that we are not as prosperous. The final one, police. Control with force. This video is pretty short compared to the other one, but that's mostly because I didn't do the 7-minute intro and there's only 4 instead of 5. Example I gave was the BATF, which is an abbreviation for the Bureau of alcohol, tobacco, firearms, and explosives. They don't have the E on it for some reason. And I didn't write it on here, but the FBI. And another one is FEMA, who is not strictly a police organization, but which can be a police organization because they can take away our rights, they can seize some things from us, and they can act as police in certain national emergencies. And that's what they do. They even have, there are even documents that show that FEMA sets up, has camps like concentration camps or internment camps that aren't being used but which could be used in the future, and they want to build more as well. And they control with force. They try to force you to do what they want, and this ties in with the other things. The police can be used in the future when the New World Order actually rises, although they have one right now. It's not completely structured. It's not fully into place yet. It's still building up. So the New World Order doesn't actually technically exist right now, but it does at the same time. Like, they have all of these, they have each of the levels controlling the others or having influence over the others, but there is no actual one world government yet, and that's what they're working towards. But the police, in the future and in the past, will be used to enforce many of these. Obviously, some of them they can't really enforce, but probably in the future they will be used to enforce certain religions, the one world religion, and the Bible talks about that, how if you don't worship the beast, you don't do what they say, if you don't follow their one world religion, they'll cut your head off, they'll torture you, they'll do all kinds of things to you. The courts, which I talked about yesterday, they'll try to enforce the 2.4 million laws that exist in the United States that we don't really need. Most of them we don't need, and they'll put you into prison if you don't, or arrest you and then put you in jail and then take you to a court for trial if you don't follow the laws. They'll probably also in the future do something like enforce certain health things, like force vaccinations, force you to drink your fluoridated water, something like that, force you to go to school, your public re-education centers, and force you to pay taxes, obviously. And if you try to stand up to them, like I said, the BATF, the FBI are two examples I gave. They can do some things to you. Like I was explaining earlier, how the CIA is partially responsible for the assassination of John F. Kennedy. Well, so is the FBI, and people like John Edgar Hoover, who was a major part of the assassination, who actually admitted it on his deathbed. When people like John F. Kennedy tried to stand up to the New World Order, groups like the FBI are told to fight against him, to fight against people in the government who are trying to stand up to them. John F. Kennedy wanted to get rid of the CIA. That's one of the reasons why the CIA was involved. He preferred diplomacy over war. He didn't want to go to Vietnam, which was something that the Vatican did want, because Ingo, I don't even know how to pronounce his first name, Dinh Diem, the ruler of South Vietnam, who they call a president, but he was actually a dictator, was a Catholic dictator. He persecuted Buddhists, and he was the pawn of the church, and the only reason why the Vietnam War was fought wasn't to stop communism. Although it was, because the Catholic Church did oppose communism, even though because it's not like their version of socialism, which has to do with religion, while communism is complete separation of church and state and persecution of anybody who tries to have organized religion or and trying to shut down churches like that, or churches and organized religious groups. But, so, like I said, Kennedy didn't want to go to Vietnam. He opposed many of the decisions by the CIA. He opposed Operation Northwoods. So both the CIA and the FBI didn't want him around. They assassinated him. The BATF, which was responsible for the murder of many women and children in the Waco massacre during 1993, where they could have just easily arrested David Koresh, who wasn't really that much of a criminal. Most of the things that were said about him on TV were just propaganda. He didn't do a lot of the things they said he did. He was just a regular old religious leader, although I wouldn't agree with him on the topic of if he was right or not. I think he was wrong. I believe he said that he was the Messiah, or that the Messiah was returning in just a few years or something like that. I disagree with him on that, but he was not really a bad person. They were trying to make him out to be, and they asked him if he had any weapons, and he offered to let the BATF actually come in to their church and look around it to see if they have any weapons. So it wasn't really a shootout. It was mostly just people. There's actually evidence on certain documentaries that the soldiers of the BATF killed their own men and to try and pin the blame on them. They shot through the windows where certain officers or agents or whatever you call them walked in, and then their other their comrades, I guess, shot through the windows or shot through the doors and shot them dead. And because nobody in the church had any weapons, it was a complete massacre. They had tanks, they had all kinds of weapons, they had chemical warfare, biological warfare, and they just murdered people. That it's a disgusting display of power, and that's how they try to control with force the police. Many police, although yes, it is very many groups like Black Lives Matter, they exaggerate when it comes to how the police are treating certain groups. I don't believe that there's really any. Yes, there is racism, obviously, in the police force, but it's not as great as people try to make it out to be. However, there is still police brutality, and it has nothing to do with race. It's just that that many police officers think that they're better than everyone else, and that they think that they have power and that they can control people. And this has happened all the time. So I've gone through 9 areas of control briefly. I haven't really explained the history and how many of the certain groups inside of these 9 areas have operated, and how they're connected to corporations and banks and other groups up here. I've just gone through brief 5 to 10 minute summaries on each of these, and this is my first 2 episodes of this series, explaining the 9 areas of control. So I hope you enjoy, and I hope you learn some things. It's mostly just, what was that? Anyway, it's just mostly just an explanation of how the government uses these 9 areas to control you. I didn't really mention any specific events, but I could go into a lot more detail. I could spend, I could make an entire episode on each of these, but if I did, then this entire series would take forever to produce, so that would be 9 extra episodes, so I'm just not going to do that. But I will continue to make videos on the New World Order. I will go through all of these, and I'll probably do a wrap-up or an explanation of how you can how you can leave Babylon, how you can remove yourself from this beast system, and live in the way that the Creator wants you to live. And I'll make a video on that after I'm done with this, and then I'll go on to the history, starting from the very beginning when Constantine converted to Christianity. He pretty much just invented Christianity, invented Catholicism, and going on all the way until the present day. So, this is episode 2. I hope you enjoy. Come back for more videos, and that is all. Goodbye.